thought, let's have an exercise in sharing, so I brought 35, please. Was I being truthful there? Good question. Robin, if you could dish them out on that side. The reason for this is that if I go to talks, because I have a hidden disability, I like to see the notes while it's going on so that I can write them. And I think probably about a third of the people are writing avidly. So this is less writing, more concentration, and I hope it works for some of you. But if you wouldn't mind sharing, that would be brilliant. And it will mean some sharing along the back row too, Rosie. Is that all right? You're a bit like a magician putting these things across, but I'm not. There's nobody no white rabbit's going to jump out. As Eva said, I was in my focus for the next 15 minutes. Is what did I wish we had known before we started? I went to talks like the excellent one that Will has given, and that ramped up my enthusiasm. But I still find it was much more complicated than I knew, and that meant we had serious delays during the work. This is our story. This is my wife Mary and myself. And it begins with downsizing from a 5 to 6 bedroom house. Sorry, we haven't got a picture of it, which was detached and 3 floors. And we bought a 110-year-old terraced house, 3 bedroom, facing south. The point to make here is not least about the deaths due to cold in Bath, is that the most energy efficient thing is to use a house the size that you need. We bought this house. You can see the back of it. I can't point to it. I'm sorry about the quality of our backdrop. We went, first of all, to redesign the house. So we had this back-facing. What was the south-facing doing? It was a downstairs loo and a coal shed. So we replaced it with the construction on the right, which lets lots of sun in. And one of the things I didn't realise is how much energy we've saved simply by having that opened up to the heat. I went next door to my neighbour, whose house is the same as the one on the left, and he's freezing. And I took my shirt off this morning, sitting there. Anytime through the winter, you've got the solar gain. It's so well worth doing. Why were we doing this? Well, I think there are about 3 or 4 reasons. All of them are self-interest. Why bother about the people in Bangladesh? Because if we don't reduce global warming, then we're going to have a chaotic warm world. War might have been the right word to slip out by mistake in 20, 30 years' time. The other reason, which wasn't mentioned by Will, is that if we spend increasing amounts of our money on fuel, then that takes more and more money out of the local economy and exports it to Malaysia and places like that, which are our energy companies. Will has covered the energy hierarchy. We didn't understand it at the beginning, and I wish we had, because the energy hierarchy helps sort out what one should do. There's lots of ideas, lots of messages. You would think that the government was saying the best thing to do is solar PV. So we came across all sorts of thicknesses of insulation. Which one do we use? Here's a fabric. This has got to be good. Well, actually, we discovered that the company who makes something like that said, don't use it whatever you do in your situation. So the energy hierarchy helped. And I'll illustrate how we used it, but we didn't understand that we were using it. First of all, conserve energy. And you'll see we had a great big thickness of this on our walls. Okay? Then, the loft insulation. And this is what we did in the loft. Talking about what we did, but I'm trying to illustrate how the energy hierarchy and other things that we gradually learned helped. The second thing is conserve energy, so you want low value, low The efficient gas fire moved us from 40% to 80% efficiency. The gas boiler moved us from 40 to 88% efficiency. This resulted in a reduction of 60%. Well, it is being measured now, but it is an estimated reduction of about 67%. That's the story. I came back to the energy hierarchy again. I think you've had enough on that. Here's a pictorial representation of how much energy you use through your roof and your walls combined, 35, 25, 40, 60%. So that's the thing to work on, but of course there are difficulties, as Will pointed out. What's amazing is 15% out through drafts. And I'll come back to that further on. So we went through an envelope of insulation, going around the house. I talked about the confusion about where we use the foil, how thick it should be, what's the best way to fit it. Now you notice there in the fitting process, again, I apologize, I can't see here, but there is foil backs, which is the foil back of this one. There, the one at the bottom. And then another insulation on top. And the critical thing was to put tape over there, over the joints, to have it well fitting. Now, I went to an architect designed house, and he was really pleased. And there were these great gaps between these rafters and the insulation. And it was just held there with toggles. So it was learning about those small details, which, when you come to you get the general presentation, aren't necessarily so clear, and architects and builders don't necessarily know about them. So it was finding out about the best way to do these things. To our benefit, along came Martin and Steve of the Clean Footprint. And Martin says to me, Oswald, why bother putting in what is the current regulation, building regulation, when you could do the maximum and achieve what the building regulations would be in 5 or 10 years' time. Absolute, utter wisdom. Those of you who've been insulating your lofts, how many people insulated their lofts with some roly-poly stuff? One? Only one. Well, there's a market here. Okay. Do you remember it started off with 2 inches? Yes? And it's now the recommended depth is 12 inches, which in new money is, I can't remember. Lots. And it's free now. But the point I'm making is, what Martin said to us is, why don't you go for the equivalent of 12 inches around here? But that still left us with an issue about specification. So, the challenge for you, for me, was to know how much to put in, where, how, and when. Sorry, and what precautions to take to avoid condensation. But the regulations are the minimum, and they're treated as the maximum. So what specification did we go for? We used the code for sustainable homes. And wait for it, on the back of your information pack are some small, you like it when you go to presentations and people put fingers up there you can't see? On the back, you'll see code level 3, you share it across. If everyone shares across, and you look at page code level 3,